So tell me how you introduce yourself to a new puppy that you want them to do something that's hard for them.
First off, I think dogs talk in body language, so I think approaching a dog is very positive, where the previous puppy was pretty scared of the world, so just holding her, petting her. Same thing with him. He has a very nice eye as well. If a dog... I'll come up underneath the dog's chin to pet instead of over the top of the head. That way I can come in more of a submissive position instead of up on the top. Especially with little dogs, people tend to always come in, and when they come in to say hello, they always come this direction. And this can be very, very intimidating. I don't know if you couldn't see his eyes, but his body language, he stopped. He stopped licking the treat. It was much more intimidating to have a hand coming on top of him than it was to be underneath. And so if I... Is that hard to chew? There you go. I do a lot of talking to my dogs, not necessarily because my dogs understand what I'm saying, but because dogs talk in body language. I can talk in a nice tone, and that sets my body in a nice tone. So I can carry over to that. I know that we're working on leash manners, but... Hi! What you doing? That's good stuff, huh? So he's very people friendly. Hi. For him, I would have super small treats. So again, back to body language. I talk to my dogs in body language. If I come up underneath, I can just give a little rub to the jowls. I can kind of come down on the chest a little bit. Where he's starting to offer kisses, I understand that he's friendly. If he was frozen, I might reconsider. I might not come in underneath. I'm definitely not going to come in over on the top of a dog, especially if he has fear or, that was a big pizza, or if he has any insecurities. So now we know he's happy. He's got his tail up. He's wagging. He's coming into my lap. So he's gonna completely build off the confidence of a human being. You can tell as he's starting to get up into the car goes by, he stops and he looks at it and he comes back to check into me. Hey, is that okay? And he's on my
job. Good job. Charlie. Come on, Daddy.
So I'm gonna give little teeny taps to the leash, just so he understands the direction that I want him to go to. Come on, Charlie.
Atta boy. Good job.
Atta boy. Are you ready? Let's go. I don't care where he's walking with me right now, because I'm just trying to introduce him to a leash, but he's tethered to you. Atta boy. Touch positive to my dog.
Charlie. Hi, I know they look like they're having fun, huh? Yeah, boy. Good job. Good boy. Good job.
And what do you mean by your touch positive?
If I'm gonna come in and reach at my dog, I wanna make sure that he understands, especially at the beginning, that touch is good, touch is comfortable, touch is safe. If he becomes injured later, I want to be able to know that I can, you know, look in his teeth and make sure all of his teeth are good. I can look in his feet and make sure his toenails are good and the pads of his feet. But by creating a trust immediately that my hands aren't going to hurt you, I'm starting to create a positive.